Hello, I cannot wait for everybody to come back to church. I hate this. How many people hate it? Yeah. I miss my church family so much. Well, we were last night, thought we were going to have to take our dog to the emergency vet. We were on the way, and I found where you can actually talk to a vet online for $5. So I did that, and after we gave her a bath, she just couldn't breathe. And now I think it was because she got so worked up that she's got the same stuff in her lungs that I do. He told us to go get some children's Mucinex and give her that, and it took care of it. Yeah, so we're all suffering, but with the pollen, but we have overcome in Jesus Christ, and I've got to confess that and speak it, and every Easter, Resurrection Sunday, I have always just been sick with a sinus infection, and praise God, I have not had that this year. I've got the congestion, but I hadn't moved into a sinus infection, so I'm praising the Lord for that. I'm learning. All right, so last week we started a study on prayer, so I'm going to pick up where we left off last week. And might have thought that, that sounds like a boring topic, but I guarantee you that it's not going to be boring, and I'm going to challenge you, and I may even make you mad. Last week we left off talking about Proverbs chapter 23, verse 7, and it says, that as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Proverbs 23:7. And we established what the Bible calls your heart. Your heart is made up of your mind, will, emotions, and your spirit. So it's all the different parts of you made up into one is what the Bible calls your spirit. I think everybody will agree, you don't really know the real me, okay? Do I really know the real me? You know? I can only know what you tell me. All right? Now, I can know things through the Spirit, where the Spirit will tell me things about somebody, or the Spirit will tell me something about me. Okay? Maybe that I'm blind to really things about me. So I think nobody can really know anybody to the depth that God knows you through your Spirit. So you see, somebody can be entertaining suicidal thoughts and we'd never know it, right? Unless they let on, unless they tell somebody, or unless the Holy Spirit tells you. So why? Because we're spirit beings, all right? And you're a spirit being housed in a body, all right? And our heart, our soul, our mind, will, and emotions, and our spirit that make up the heart, and that is tucked away safely where nobody can see it. All right? But guess who can see it? God can. And unless you let it manifest in actions, attitudes, or words, nobody's going to see it. But if you let any of that show, then I can pretty well tell you, and you can in me also, who is sitting on the throne of our heart. Because what does it say in Proverbs? As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. All right, so if you give me some indication of what you're thinking, I can tell you who's sitting on your heart's throne. And you can mine as well. All right, so what I'm saying is, we don't need, and I'm preaching to me, so don't get mad, we don't need medicine. We need to renew our minds. Mm-hmm. All right? So the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5, casting down arguments and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Casting down arguments. Who's arguing with us? Satan. We hear demon spirits talking to us on a regular basis, okay? He tells us lies, just like he did in the garden. It's no different, all right? And he says we have to cast those arguments down and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. All right, now that was a quick recap of what we went over last week. All right, so now what does all this have to do with prayer, you're probably asking? Well, the Word tells us that all we need to know about living a joyful life is in that book. Okay? But see, the problem is we don't read it. All right? And then if we do read it, we just skim it and we don't take time. And something has really struck me this week. Those scriptures, and I have one scripture that I put in one of our bathrooms, and that scripture, just one, over the last few weeks has literally come alive in me. Because I read it every time I go in there, okay? And there's something about that. There's something about taking one scripture and reading it over and over and over again that does something to you. It literally passes from here to here, okay? And it'll change your life. So whatever you have need of, find a scripture, put it somewhere where you're going to read it over, and I'm talking weeks. Just let it sit there for weeks, but just make sure you read it. And I guarantee you, it will change you. It will come alive. All right? And so I'm going to challenge you. If your life is not joyful, all right, which Paul told us it can be under any circumstance, then you need to listen carefully to this teaching. Because the Word tells us how to be joyful, how to have an abundant life, how to feel good, how to get up in the morning and be happy. All right, and he tells us that to get to that state, we have to renew our minds. That's the whole key. That's it in a nutshell. And so he says to be carnally minded is death, Romans 8:6. I mean, how much more clear can we get? I've read that scripture all my life, and that's the one that I've got in my bathroom right now. And it has just come alive to me. Oh my gosh. As long as I think carnally, I'm going to receive death. Period. Okay? So who wants death to reign in their life? Well, how does death reign in your life? It reigns in your life with crippling depression, anxiety, panic attacks, suicide thoughts, anything. All of that is death. All right? But see, what do? We run to the doctor to get a drug for that. All right? And I really don't know anybody who has really can say that the drug has delivered them.
No.
Okay.
Cause more problems. They didn't have to take another drug to counteract that problem.
Right. All right. So if you want to stop all this, okay, if you prefer to have all this stopped instead of just putting a Band-Aid on it with a pill, all right, then we have to take what the Word says, and then it says to be carnally minded is death. But to be spiritually minded is life and peace. All right, if you want life and peace in your life, raise your hand. Okay, all right. So, I'm not going to go down the rabbit trail of people who enjoy being sick. Okay, because there are people who enjoy that. They enjoy the attention. They enjoy the disability. They enjoy all that. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to people who are sick and tired of being sick and tired. So the crux of the matter is it's up to you to choose. See, I can't make you do it. You can't make me do it. Jesus can't make you do it. Because he made us free, volitional, willed people. And it's up to you to choose. So if you choose for your mind to be stayed on the Lord all day, and you don't allow these thoughts to continue that are contrary to his work on the cross, then guess what? You will be in a state of prayer all day long. You'll even be in a state of prayer during your sleep. All right? And then you won't even need to set aside a special time of prayer, because you will find that you are communing with God all day long. All right? So that's how that ties into prayer. All right, now that might have gone right over some of your heads, so I'm going to say it again. You have to choose who sits each and every day on the throne of your heart. See, because every day is a new day. And every day, Satan is going to come, and he wants to be on the throne of your heart. All right, now what's the throne of your heart? The throne of your heart is your mind. What are you looking at?
It's a loss.
Oh. Well, I rebuke it in Jesus' name.
We got a swamp.
I don't think so. I don't know. You can look. All right. So if you let Satan sit on the throne of your heart, all right, because he brought a thought to you, See, when he brings the thought, you have to decide, am I going to go down that trail? Am I going to open it up? Am I going to open up my mind to him? Am I going to think about him? Am I going to let him sit on the throne of my heart? Or am I going to kick him off? The Bible says to catch that thought, okay? And it means to catch it like a bird. So a bird's flying over your head, and he's going to poop on your head, so you catch him before he does that. All right, so it's up to us what we do. All right, and who you let sit on your throne every day. All right, now guess what? See, what he does is he baits us. That's all he does is he baits us. He gives you a thought, just like he did Eve, and he's baiting you. And he's waiting.